Okay, so just a little rundown of where we are so far. We've got the airplane drawn out. We've got it marked out where we're going to drill the holes for the wheels, where we're going to route for the front wheel, where we're going to put the pegs for the wings. We're going to route for the vertical stabilizer and the horizontal stabilizers. So you can see we've come 1 inch from the edge and 3 inches long and then an inch down. So likewise, on this guide I've got set up, we're 1 inch from there, which is the center of the blade, and then it's 3 inches long, so we'll know to start right there when this thing turns on, and we'll route all the way to here where I've got where it says stop. So we've got a quarter inch router bit in here. The depth is half an inch. You don't want it too deep because you're gonna have to drop both sides, so you don't want it to go all the way through. So I guess we can go ahead and start. So we'll line that up and then lift it off of the blade, turn it on. And then there we go. Okay, so we're ready to do the other side of the airplane. We're gonna route for the other horizontal stabilizer. I flipped my guide around as far as measurements go, so now I'm 1 inch this way, and then with the board like that, so 2.5. So I'll repeat the same process at the board at the start. My guide slipped. These tables aren't worth a damn to clamp to. Be a very easy route, I don't think. Now we'll do the same thing for the vertical stabilizer. What I did was I left this where it was, this guy, and then I put my 2x4 in here. There's a little spacer so I can get where this needs to be exactly, because we don't want it to move around here. The route's going to look crooked. The distance for the vertical stabilizer is going to be the same is there, so as long as we have this lined up on that blade, we can use this guide right here for that also. So we'll do it just like before. Line it up on start. Make a little adjustment. Before I route for the front wheel, I'm going to go ahead and drill the holes for the wheels. So, get that marked out. So let's go ahead and do that too. So now we're going to route for the front wheel so it can be in the center. I've changed the blade out to a half inch blade. I've also adjusted the height to half an inch. So, I'm going to use the same methodology. I'm going to use the same way of doing it. Okay, we got everything drilled. We have everything routed. So now, we're going to cut the free slide out. Okay, now we got to cut out. And it is a little bit rough in some spots, like here on the nose. That's fine, because I have a belt sander. Okay. Now I've drawn out the wing. This is just a piece of cedar closet lining. And what I've done is I've measured 22 inches. That's how long I want the completed wing. Find the midpoint. I came off 3/4 inch on each side for 1.5 inches total width there where it's going to mount to the plane. And then I came up 1.25 inches on the edges. And then I just drew a straight line with a 12-inch speed square. So now I'm gonna cut this bad boy out and then take it over to the belt sander. Quick check just to see how this is all fitting together. We got these holes right here that we're gonna attach the wing with using pegs. And what we're gonna do now is we're gonna use that same measurement as we used here. Is 1 inch from the sides, and we've already got the middle, so we just take 1 inch, mark that, inch, mark that, drill it, and then we'll be able to put the wing. Okay, what I've gone ahead and done is I took one of the wheels, put it in our route. I got some glue on the outside and on just the inside of this hole. You don't want too much because you want the wheel to spin. And then I stuck that dowel in. It left a little bit on the other side, about 1/2 inch, give or take. And so I stuck this other pin in there. So what we're going to do now is we're going to cut that off, and then we're going to take it to the belt sander and sand that flush. I'm using 1/2 inch oak to make my engines. They're going to be 1 inch wide a piece with holes drilled in the front for propellers. Those are going to be 1 inch deep. These ones right here will be about 1/4 inch deep. And they're 1 3/4 long. Wing that's ready for the sander. Now I've gone ahead and drilled the holes through these propellers here. I used a 5/16 bit because it's going on a 1/4 inch dowel and I want it to spin pretty good or pretty well. I took the dowels and I went ahead and cut them. They were 1 inch long. I just cut a whole bunch of it off because they can't stick in there the whole way because there's going to be another peg going in right there. I'm also going to have to cut that. So what I'm going to do is get a little bit of wheel glue right there on that board. I'm going to poke the dowel through. I'm going to dip a little bit of glue on there. Very carefully, don't want to get it on the propeller. Then I'm gonna put that in the forward hole of that engine. Now they can be a little bit snug, so you want to be careful. Now we're gonna, after we get done doing that, the holes that we've pre-drilled on the wing, we're gonna repeat that process again. I had to shorten the dowel quite a bit. It'll probably still stick up some. but it's because I'm using different engines from the first one I built. So now what we're going to do is we're going to take the engine. Some wood glue on there. Take the dowel, get some wood glue on it. And I'm place that dowel. Okay, engines are on the wing. Wings ready to go on. But first, I want to do the wheels because if I end up having to hammer them in, it's going to be real hard to do with the wing on there. So now, start to come together. We need to do those on the other side and then put the wing. Thank you.